Still don't have a clue who the guy is.
Your son's been shot.
Daddy knows.
We're working together as a team to solve this case.
Evening.
10:27 p.m., 4919 Olive. Sergeant Dave Bernard, a 23-year veteran, gathers his squad.
During this 28-day period, I've got seven detectives.
All we got is some dispatch on the sound of shots.
Officers had the name of the lady who called it in. She's up here, elderly lady. She didn't say she just heard the shots.
So basically, we don't have anything.
No clues, no witnesses, no suspects. That's why the murder squad gets called out.
And then when we get an understanding of what they know, then I will assign detectives different tasks.
I wonder if that one, that bullet came right up.
Eric Dillenkoffer will lead the investigation.
One detective will handle the crime scene investigation. He is usually, or she is usually, the one that will keep that case down. That's assigned to them for the rest of their career.
Sergeant Bernard stays with a victim who's been shot multiple times. The rest of the squad canvasses the neighborhood.
He hears what he thinks is backing up, and then he hears the shots. Here's boom, boom, boom. He looks out his window.
Well, our first clue.
A white truck, no longer at the scene.
Was there any shell casings?
Nothing.
No.
Nothing. There's a bullet laying there by his head.
The medical examiner identifies the man from a piece of paper in his pocket. The victim, Myron Evans. Now detectives need a suspect.
Your son's been shot.
2 detectives leave the scene, assigned the difficult task of informing Myron's family.
Okay.
Your son didn't make it.
Hours into the investigation, a hot lead.
Bullet holes in the door and a few shot in the truck.
Several blocks from the murder scene, the victim's white pickup truck.
When you get a good lead, you think this is the one. Boy, it perks everybody up if you've been there already 20 hours. You know, this may be the one and you're ready to go on it.
Well, it adds credibility to our one and only witness.
That witness gave detectives something else, the name of the suspect. Okay, 9:07 a.m. Medical examiners perform an autopsy on Myron Evans.
How many does it look like we've got in his torso?
Detective Dan Phillips takes careful notes.
Well, and then he's got fragments of either that one or there's maybe two there.
But what about the torso? If we're calling three of those entry, one of them exit.
Yeah, let's see.
See what I mean? There ought to be something in them.
The medical examiner looks for a bullet inside Myron's body that could lead detectives to the type of gun the suspect used.
Like, we may not have the actual slug, but I'll let you know. Thanks, brother. Bye.
12:10 p.m. The entire squad meets at headquarters downtown.
We're going to have, if we can, daily briefings, maybe twice a day, so that every detective knows what every other detective knows.
Well, I didn't know if you wanted to take a picture of it. I could just snatch it up.
A cell phone battery found near the victim's truck led detectives to the suspect, Clinton Wilson. Officers arrest him on drug charges.
He supposedly comes home, tells her that he shot a guy in the chest.
Detective Jeff Cowdery talked to the suspect's girlfriend.
It was really neat because we were talking about the night of the homicide, and she's like, boom, 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 boom. And I asked what she did last Sunday, and she's like,
And the suspect's mother.
She was worried about blood being in her car. Because she got all upset. Did you shoot him in my car? She said, no, I shot him in his car. She's like, oh, that's okay.
11:20 p.m. The murder squad obtains a search warrant for the suspect's house. The tactical squad will secure the house so detectives can safely search for the murder weapon.
And of course, our suspect lives there too, but he's in jail tonight.
Go play, true. Guys. Go play.
Rock up.
You guys locked and loaded?
Police department, search warrant, open the door.
The TAC team has done their job. The rest is up to detectives. The only people in the house, Wilson's mother and brother, they're taken in for questioning.
Mama said in her bedroom, in the closet, in a shoe, is a gun.
The search for the weapon continues well into the night.
You guys want to take a break and cool off out here?
Yeah, you mind if I have a cigarette?
No.
But comes up empty. Detectives' next move? Interrogate the suspect, Clinton Wilson, and hope he confesses. 2:20 p.m. Clinton Wilson hasn't been told why detectives want to talk to him.
It'll be somewhat of a shock to him, but I think he knows.
How you doing, Clinton? I'm Detective Dylan Coffer. This is Detective Hutchison here.
Most of the time, we've already got a plan.
Before we start, he just wants to get a little bit of information.
We size this individual up psychologically to a certain extent. We know something about his history.
Obviously, we know, you know, we know what happened. We don't know why it happened, okay? And the only person that knows that is you.
They interplay with each other very well.
Detectives Hutchison and Dylan Coffer slowly wear Wilson down.
You gotta understand, you gotta get it clear in your head that now's the time. You know, this isn't going away, Clinton.
Finally, Wilson confesses to killing Myron Evans.
You know what I'm saying? You're just sitting there grinning and smiling, that's not shoddy.
Okay. Where'd you have the gun at?
In my pocket.
The most important phrase that they can hear is when some detective comes out of the interrogation room and says he gave it up.
You're tired. You've worked hard on this case. There's always that underlying stress and that underlying pressure, and when it happens, it's just, it's gone. I mean, it's like the clouds clearing and the sun coming out.
Hi, it's Detective Dylan Carr for the police department. Doing good. Well, hopefully I have a little bit of good news for you, given the situation.
Detective Dylan Coffer calls the victim's family.
Okay, if you could just let her know. All right, thank you very much. Bye. Daddy knows. He's going to let Mama know. This is what we work for, all of us down here. These are the type of cases that we work for. That's where the excitement is. That's where the challenge is.
That challenge will be repeated in the next 24 hours. Clinton Wilson will spend 22 years in prison for the first-degree murder of Myron Evans. His sentence includes 15 years for armed criminal action and 4 years for knowingly setting Evans' truck on fire.